nice and early this morning. We travelled down to Watford, but what are we here to see, Joe?
We're here to see the installation of an EV charge point, and we're looking at one that we've not seen installed before. We're going to see the installation of a Tesla charger, so that's going to be interesting.
We're here with MJ Electrical Services. You're going off to speak to Matt, and I'm going to go and find Kev and grab myself a cup of tea.
Let's get started.
Hello, mate. How are you doing, Kev?
Cup of tea?
Love a cup of tea. I've left Joe with Matt doing the technical stuff, so it's important that we get refreshed.
Absolutely.
This is Matt of MJ Electrical. Good to see you, Matt.
Morning, Joe.
I'd offer to shake your hand, but we're still mid-COVID, so that can't happen. Matt. Absolutely. This is a really nice moment for me because Matt was in one of the very first groups that I ever taught at the college, and we've kind of obviously gone our separate ways for a long time and just circled back together.
12 which years.
Is, yeah. And you're like married and stuff?
Married, yeah.
Madness. Madness. He was a boy when I started teaching him, but there we go. I think I've weathered every bit as well as Matt has.
I'd say so, yeah.
That's very kind of you. So let's talk a little bit more about this installation, Matt. So we're installing an EV charge point. It's going outside and the car is likely to charge outside. So what are some of the considerations that you've taken for this installation?
So if we start from the supply side of this, we've got a three-phase board in there, linked out, single-phase tails.
Okay.
We're going to be installing the circuit surface in the inside of the garage.
Nice.
So we don't need to have any considerations for RCD protection on the circuit.
For the cable.
Yep. For the cabling, yep. So we're just going to install the MCB in the board to supply. We've had to buy a Garo PEN monitor.
Okay, yeah, so it's looking for PME faults.
Yep. As the Tesla charger don't have this integrated into their devices.
Yeah.
So we're going to supply that. That's also got a Type B RCD built into it. Has to be Type B RCD due to the high levels of DC current that the Tesla puts back into the circuit.
Fantastic.
Apart from that, We've got the height set at 1.2 there, in accordance with your video.
He's a good lad, isn't he? I taught him everything he knows. Yeah, very good. No, that's fantastic. So it's nice. Clearly a lot of thought gone into this. So we're gonna go and have a look at some of the installation work next. That'd be brilliant.
Excellent.
So now we'd like to pose a question for Joe. I'm going to pose one for you today, Joe. The EV charging point from Tesla doesn't qualify for the OLEV grant. Why is that?
Well, that's because the Tesla charger doesn't have internet connectivity. And in order to be approved for the OLEV grant, the charger itself has to be able to connect to the internet so that the charging process can be controlled remotely. Now, that doesn't mean that the Tesla technology is lagging behind in any way, because we know that to be completely not true. But in the case of the Tesla, the internet connectivity that controls the charging process is actually in the car itself.
Right, okay. So there's nothing stopping me, however, even though I may have a Tesla, of actually having one of the other manufacturers that do qualify?
Absolutely, yeah. You can get one of those installed under the OLEV grant and it will charge your Tesla up. But obviously, if you want to go with the full Tesla car and charger combination, then you're not going to get this approved by the OLEV grant, but that just means it gets installed without the payment from the government.
So, Kev, you've rapidly installed some mini trunking for your cable to EV charging point. Is there any of the precautions you've taken?
Yeah, obviously, in a fire condition, potentially the cable could fall.
Right.
So, as precaution, we're using an anchor fixing in the plasterboard.
I like that. That's a metal fixing. I like that.
It is, yeah. It will be securing a fire clip, which will obviously hold the cable in position inside the mini trunking.
And I can see you've put several throughout the run as well.
We have, yes.
So as always with installing an EV charging point, we've got to be thinking about the earthing arrangement, and we know the earthing arrangement here is a TNCS. Why is that so important, Joe?
Well, that's so important because, of course, we know that the PEN conductor, if that becomes disconnected out in the road, that's going to raise all of the metalwork in the building up to 230 volts, and potentially that could include the bodywork of the car, which then means if you're outside, you've got a reasonable contact with the literal earth, you touch the car, that's going to lead to an accident. So there has to be some equipment in place to try and prevent that from happening. And Matt's decided that he's going to install here this unit from Garo, which offers protection against broken pens. So it's got, first of all, it's got this RCD in here. First of all, that's a Type B RCD.
And the RCD now is actually going to be fitted at the installation at the mains end. Well, we didn't think it was at the start. So the cable itself is now RCD protected. Does it need to be jugged?
It doesn't. Because the cable's been surface mounted, it's not buried in the wall, it doesn't need RCD protection because there's no chance that someone's going to drill through it accidentally. So we've kind of got incidental RCD protection for the cable.
And how is it going to know if there is a pen fault? This Garo unit, how will it detect that pen fault?
Well, that's where this clever bit comes in here. So what we've got here is a bit of kit that monitors the voltages. Now, that's to comply with indent 4 of regulation 722.411.4. And that actually means that this can be connected to a TNCS system, because if the voltage goes above 253 volts or drops below 207 volts, then this device will disconnect this contactor. And you'll notice that wired through that, you've got the line, the neutral, and the CPC as well, which allows you to be in full accordance with indent 4.
By disconnecting the protective conductor under those circumstances.
Absolutely. So we're at the stage where you're connecting up the charger itself, Matt. Now, for a lot of electricians thinking about going into the world of EV charger installation, they're probably really nervous about the actual connecting up and what complicated connections need to be made inside the charger there. So can you just talk us through what you've got? Are you struggling a bit there?
Yeah, no, I can understand that. There was a bit of head scratching. Got the notebook out, drew a few wiring diagrams.
Yeah.
Then opened the cover and saw live, neutral, and earth. So
nice.
Yeah.
So it's basically just a glorified shower, isn't it? That
yes,
you're connecting
it is.
Up there.
Very simple to connect.
Very nice. Yeah. So line, neutral, CPC, and you're away.
And Tesla have given us a nice bit of room to work in as well. So it's always an added bonus.
Again, thank you, Elon Musk. What a guy. We've had a really good day with Matt and Kevin today. Thank you both very much for your time.
Matt, good to see you.
It's been really good. We've seen the smooth process of the charger being installed. It didn't present too many challenges at all, which is nice. We're not going to subject you to the testing procedure. We've covered how to do that on a different video on the channel, so go and check that out. But we are at that most exciting moment now where we get to remove the protective film from the front of the charger, like that lovely moment when you take it off your new phone. So we're going to let Matt have that privilege.
Goes against the grain a bit for me, because I usually leave it on.
Yeah,
I'm having my tester.
I noticed you had that on your tester
yeah,
still, but we've got to go for it.
Here we go.
Look at that. Lovely and satisfying. Very good. So thanks again, gents.
Thanks for coming down.